Pi'olani Community College started as a technical school in 1946 and was originally located on the corner of Kapi'olani Boulevard and Pensacola Street behind McKinley High School. Like the other 9 campuses in the University of Hawaii system that are named after geographical areas or places, KCC's name originally came from its location on Kapi'olani Boulevard. When the college moved to its present location at the foot of Diamond Head in the 1980s, it kept the name because Kapi'olani, the boulevard, was actually named after a person, a queen of Hawaii. Thus came the responsibility to learn more about its namesake. Kapi'olani Community College bears the name of Queen Julia Kapi'olani. She was the wife of King David Kalakaua, who reigned as Hawaii's 7th monarch from 1874 to 1891. In the Hawaiian culture, names are important and pronunciation is critical. In a very old olelo no eau, or wise saying, it states, Ika olelo no ke ola, ika olelo no kamake, which means, in the word there is life, in the word there is death. The Hawaiian language was a spoken language until the missionaries arrived in 1820 and put it into written form. Thus, when Hawaiians of old referred to olelo, or word, they meant the spoken word. Hawaiians believe that names have mana, or spiritual power. Using a name of an ancestor, then, draws on that ancestor's spiritual power. They also believe that names have meaning and can help to define a person's identity. So what does Kapi'olani mean? Said correctly, with a glottal, or okina, between the I and the O, it means the arch of heaven. This usually causes people to think of a rainbow, but when the ancient Hawaiians used the word pi'o, they were thinking of the highest part of the heavens. Thus, it was used to refer to very high-ranking ali'i, or chiefs. It is a beautiful name, and when said correctly, Kapi'olani, we are drawing on the power of a queen. Please do not say Kapi'olani, because to pio something means to extinguish, as in a flame. You don't want to extinguish heaven. Queen Julia Kapi'olani was born on December 31, 1834. She was the granddaughter of Kaumualii, the famous chief of Kauai, who negotiated peace with Kamehameha the Great in 1810. She married David Kalakaua in 1863, and he was elected king in 1874. King Kalakaua's nickname was Merry Monarch, and there is an annual hula festival in Hilo honoring him for celebrating the Hawaiian culture by allowing public performances of the hula after it had been hidden for some 60 years. While King Kalakaua focused on affairs of state, Queen Kapi'olani turned her attention to helping the least fortunate in society. In 1884, she paid a visit to Kalaupapa on the island of Molokai in response to letters written to her by those who had been sent there because they were diagnosed with leprosy. In Kalaupapa, she visited every home, asked how she could help, and listened to their concerns. Upon returning to Oahu, the Queen sent individual care packages to over 700 patients, providing them with the items they requested, including clothing, shoes, and blankets. She also raised the necessary funds to build the Kapi'olani Home for Girls for those whose parents had leprosy, but they themselves did not. This was in response to parental requests to have their children raised away from Kalaupapa in hopes that they would not contract the disease. King Kalakaua's reign not only celebrated the Hawaiian culture, he also embraced emerging technologies. He built Iolani Palace to impress visitors. There, he incorporated telephones and electric lighting, new technologies in the 1880s. In the dining room of Iolani Palace, the king and queen entertained lavishly, serving nothing but the best foods and using the finest porcelain and crystal of their day. In 1881, while the palace was being built, King Kalakaua went on a 10-month world tour, visiting 25 cities, making him the first ruling monarch in the history of the world to circumnavigate the globe. The Japanese welcomed him with great pomp and circumstance, as he was the first king of a Western Christian nation to visit Japan. Knowing the value of traveling beyond Hawaii's shores, King Kalakaua also established a study abroad program, which sent 18 promising young Hawaiians to study in America, England, Scotland, Italy, Japan, and China. While Queen Kapi'olani did not accompany her husband on his world tour in 1881, she did experience an educational journey of her own when she traveled to London in 1887 to represent the Kingdom of Hawaii at Queen Victoria's Golden Jubilee celebrations. During that 106-day journey, she visited 7 cities, including New York and Washington, D.C. What Queen Kapi'olani saw at a charity hospital in New York during her 1887 journey inspired her to open the Kapi'olani Maternity Home in 1890. Having personally experienced the grief of a stillborn child when she was married to her first husband, the Queen was concerned with the health of mothers and the survival of babies. She spent the last 9 years of her life overseeing the charitable organization that ran the maternity home, using her excellent fundraising skills to finance its operations so as not to turn away any who couldn't pay. Today's Kapi'olani Medical Center for Women and Children is the Queen's enduring legacy. During that 1887 journey, Queen Kapi'olani visited over a dozen schools, including 6 for women or girls and 2 for the deaf and blind. While in Washington, D.C., she witnessed the graduation ceremony at the National Deaf-Mute College, today's Gallaudet University. After touring the facility and witnessing their proficient use of American Sign Language, she remarked to her interpreter that she hoped that such an institution might be built in Honolulu for all such afflicted children in the islands. Today, Kapi'olani Community College is perpetuating Queen Kapi'olani's legacy in a number of ways. Through its service learning and health sciences programs, KCC's students are serving their communities and becoming healthcare professionals. With its emphasis on international education and the support provided through the Deaf Center, KCC is unique among UH colleges. And through its award-winning Culinary Institute of the Pacific, Hawaii's people can experience modern fine dining at its best. While she may not have envisioned a community college bearing her name, she valued education. Thus, Kapi'olani Community College looks to Queen Kapi'olani for inspiration. As such, the college has embraced the Queen's motto, Kulia Ikanu'u, which means strive for the highest. As the only UH campus named after a person, not a place, be sure to pronounce her name correctly and strive to do your very best and make Queen Kapi'olani proud.